Okay, guys, this is a setup. Source battery there, that's the voltage and the current in. You see the current there is roughly 400 milliamps. Charging these two batteries here off the recovery diode. The other one's disconnected. There was a bit more current going when I just had it running in, so just holding the same there, 26 point something. So what I'm going to do is I'll just disconnect this wire from the recovery diodes to them, those two batteries, and try to stay focused on the current in there. See, when I disconnect it, the current goes up just slightly. When I connect the diodes, the input current reduces. This one here. Okay, so yeah, that's collecting the excess voltage spikes generated in the primary coils. There's, at the moment, that's only one coil running there. If I disconnect the recovery here, you can see there's not too much problem. The current here only goes up a little bit. But if I kick in the second coil, you can see the current . This is the second coil going the opposite direction. You see the current just jump up there a little tiny bit. If I run them both the same direction, see the current jumps way up. And most of that is because it fires a neon protecting this MOSFET transistor here. Yeah, the recovery there, the MOSFETs get warm. You connect this on there. Fire them both the same way, there's no problems here. Anyway, that's what's charging those batteries. And then, of course, once you kick in a bit of power from the power usage from the secondary, the input power goes way up. And the battery's powered way up as well. The main battery does have load on it though. Okay, I'm going to see if I can burn a hole in the light bulb. seems that bulb can hold out. Not. Okay, so this is what I got going with the setup. I'm running an ignition coil from the AC here, just connected across the two, the primary one is the ignition coil. I've removed the original condenser here from the ignition coil, this one, and replaced it with one of those caps there. This is the capacitor bank so far. Microwave oven diode there to one side of the capacitor bank from the high voltage of the ignition coil. The other side of the capacitor bank to the negative. Out of the high voltage capacitors through the primary coil of the Tesla coil. Out the primary coil. Jump the spark gap and back to negative. The bottom of the secondary coil. Here I've got a little extra inductance on in there. And the bottom is connected to that there, as well as the wire hanging over the top. So there it is. Pretty easy, basic. Oh no.